paella are pretty simple. In this particular paella, 107, we've used salt, olive oil, garlic, onion, tomatoes, a special tomato paste, short grain rice, broth, saffron, and of course our meats are shrimp, chicken, pork, and turkey sausage. Finally, you'll be able to garnish your paella with peppers, peas, lemon, and parsley. Here we are, all ready for paella. Got this. Got our rice. Everything is ready to go. We just cook up our chicken.
Okay, so here we are, putting the chicken on.
What is the next one?
This is the chicken we put in lemon chicken. Got a little recipe of lemon.
Not lemon chicken. Lemon. It's just chicken. Don't listen to this guy.
And
what's the mat for?
So the mat is so that it doesn't burn. We have a little mat.
And what's that for?
That's for vegetables.
But why can't you not put vegetables on here?
Well, I can.
But why do you don't?
They have a burn. They have a different burn mark with that. Anyway, okay, here we are. We're going to make the paella. And we have the fire going with our paella pan. Like that. Put some, we got a little prep to do here still. We're going to put a little bit of olive oil. Blended garlic. And we will add chanto, the pork. Again, we'll just fry enough to brown the outside until it finishes cooking in the paella. Okay, here we go. We're gonna make the paella now. Woohoo! We first oil.
Yeah.
And we put our salt on the side.
Hi.
This is Sergio helping. Right, Sergio, you being a helper today?
Yeah.
So we prepped everything.
Smoky. Hey, Dad, look.
Yeah.
Sure.
Oh no. Okay. That's okay. The dog can eat it. Alright, now we put our garlic.
Well, why do you put salt on the side, Dad?
That's I'm measuring the amount of salt that we have. It helps us measure.
Older!
It gives us the right amount. Supposedly the right amount. Saute our garlic, right? Until it's slightly brown?
Yeah.
Don't touch it, you make it wiggle.
Wiggle.
So we put garlic, it's browning.
Browning.
Ooh. Now, don't play around here. It's over. Now we put our onion.
Onion.
Okay, it's been sautéing for a couple minutes. Now we put the tomatoes where they come sauté.
Red stuff, remember?
This is tomato paste.
No, where's your red stuff? Like, you remember the tiny red stuff from
right
the flour?
Right there, just put it in.
What? Where?
Oh, you have to put it inside the, you're talking about the saffron.
Yeah.
I put the saffron in here already. So,
wait,
so
you're gonna put all of that in there?
No, we're gonna put the rice in here after we mix this all up. And then we're going to put that juice in there. And then we're going to add everything else. Okay?
Well, you're going to add everything else again?
Yep.
So you're going to do that whole thing again?
Yep.
I mean, like, you're going to add the sauce again. You're going to add...
Yeah, but after we get all the...
You're going to add the...
All the rice.
You're going to add all of that again?
No, that's done.
You said you're going to do everything again. You're going to do it again.
Well, everything that's not already in here. Buddy. Okay. Okay, it's looking good, buddy. All right, time to add the rice. And do 5 cups. There's 4. And there's 5. And mix all this up. Cook for a minute or two, get it all nice and mixed in so the rice soaks up the flavors of apple, garlic, and tomato. So, tomato, tomate, and cebolla or onion. Right. I typically use about a cup and a half of broth for every cup of this small grain rice. That's what we'll be pouring in here in just a second. I thought you were taking a picture of me.
No, we didn't. Hey, no.
Here we go. Here goes Sergio.
Why is it so like that? Why is it so bubbly, Dad?
Because it's a camera.
I've abs, Mom. Look. Mom, see this?
There we go. Let that cook for a couple minutes and we'll put everything in it. All right, here we go. Everything goes in now. We got our shrimp. Spread them out a little bit. And here we go. We have our chorizo. Spread everything out best you can.
Ooh.
How's that looking, Sergio?
I know if the people can't see it. No, I'll show you. Doesn't it look good?
Put it in there. Does it? So now we do the chicken.
Okay, go.
All right, now we put the garnish. Sergio, where are you going, buddy?
Birch Community Services began in 1992 with a donated bag of squished bread on the front porch of Barry and Suzanne Birch. They shared the bread with some single moms and other families in need in their neighborhood. Within the following weeks, other food retailers who had heard of the Birch's spirit of giving were donating their surplus for redistribution by the Birches to a growing number of needy families. The organization was steadily grown to become one of the largest food distribution programs in Oregon and has been within the top 25 organizations in Portland Business Journal's annual list of top 100 Portland nonprofits and has never received a penny in government funds.